What's poppin', homies? It's your favorite homegirl, Gossip Girl. Happy Friday to you all, and I hope you all are doing great so far. So today I'm doing something called Friday Fast Report, and what I'm gonna do is just share a bunch of news inside of this video, really quickly to give you some insight of what's going on, because honey, it's a lot going on. Okay, so now another rapper has been shot, and his name is Zoey Dollaz. Now Zoey Dollaz, a rep for Zoey Dollaz, or has also confirmed the shooting, releasing a statement from Zoey's close friend Donnie Dizzy Cleanface Flores, who revealed more details of what happened that night. He said that Zoey had just attended the Teyana Taylor private party when he left the parking lot. A car started following him and shot multiple times. Dizzy went on saying, "Pray for him and his family for a speedy recovery." The ironic part is he just launched a bulletproof car company for celebrities and high-end profiles people. The company was starting next week. Zoey's Instagram story post showed he was in the studio recording music on Wednesday night before celebrating Teyana's 30th birthday party in Miami with Sean, P. Diddy Combs, Trina, ASAP Ferg, and a few dozen other people. Okay, so according to NBC News, Zoey was driving on the Julia Tuttle Causeway en route to the strip club Booby Trap when the shooting happened. Okay, his black Mercedes sedan entered westbound I-195 from Alton Road just after midnight when a silver SUV pulled alongside the Mercedes and someone from inside the vehicle opened fire on the rapper's car. It just seems kind of crazy because, you know, Blue Benji, he just got shot, you know, and he was, you know, succumbed to his wounds, and he just signed to a major record company. And now this young man, who's also a rapper, who's getting ready to start a bulletproof business, you know, for cars and stuff, for celebrities and high profile people, he ended up getting shot. So there's something going on in this rap community. I'm starting to believe there's something going on in this rap community, because I don't understand why, what's with all these shootings? Something is not right. Something in the milk is spoiled, and I don't know what it is. Something is not right. Zoey was hit in the leg. He was shot 5 times and was taken to Jackson Memorial Hospital for treatment. He is reportedly in stable condition now. A female passenger was also in the car but was not injured. Okay, she wasn't injured. Wow, this is crazy. Meanwhile, Fabulous sounded off on the danger of being a rapper, calling it the most dangerous job in America. He elaborated on his remark, "Black men are surviving the trenches, constant battles in war zone environments, make something of themselves as artists, become famous, make millions of dollars, change their lifestyle, and still end up dead or in jail." And that is true. But that's crazy. This is just some crazy stuff. And I send prayers and prayers that he has a speedy recovery. You know, I'm glad he did not succumb to his wounds. But Jesus, getting shot 5 times and then in your leg. I mean, he's gonna be sitting down for a minute. He has to recover. So I wish him a speedy recovery. But what's going on out there in these streets, man? Something is going on. Something is going on. Okay, next. As you all guys know about this, Tiny, he has lost, you know, we lost Tiny, another actor. First it was Natalie, now it's Tiny, Debo, my man Debo, we have lost him. And it says that he was found by a friend dead in his apartment after experiencing COVID symptoms, okay? So it says here, Tommy Tiny Lister, best known for his roles in The Dark Knight and the Friday film series, has died at the age of 62. While he not tested positive for the novel coronavirus prior to his death, Lister died on Thursday after exhibiting COVID symptoms for a week, his manager Cindy Cohen tells People magazine. He was a gentle giant and one of a kind, she says, a man that likes a man that's like been a brother to me for over 20 years. The actor was scheduled to work on a movie over the weekend, but had canceled on Friday, according to Cohen. He was just really complaining, but he was too weak to go to the doctor, she says. So somebody should have just took him. If he was too weak to go on his own, someone, you know, hey, you should have been like, let's go. You know, if you can't take yourself, I'll take you. According to Cohen, a friend went to check up on Lister at his home after he didn't return their calls. Okay. He was found in his apartment unresponsive in the Marina Del Rey, California, according to TMZ, of course, who was the first to report on the news. The outlet reported that Lister was pronounced dead at the scene. A cause of death has not been determined. When I heard the news yesterday, it just made me sick because it seemed like 2020 is here and 2020 has been garbage. 2020 has been garbage and it's taking people out left and right. And it's like, oh my God, what else could happen? You know, what else can happen? So, you know, my condolences to his family. Debo, I can't believe he's gone. I can't believe my girl from BAPS is gone, Natalie. I can't believe both of them are gone, you know. And they say death come in threes. I don't want to hear about the next person. I just don't want to hear about no more death, period. It's just too much. It is just all too much. It's just all too much. Okay, so now the next thing we have here. A family in New York City is asking for the public's help in finding their mother's killer after authorities confirmed the body was discovered behind a building this summer, okay? Her name was Rachel Lopez, who was 47 years old. She was reported missing by her family in September of 2019. 9 months later in July, decomposed remains were found behind a building in New York City's Bronx neighborhood. This week, authorities confirmed the remains belonged to Lopez. Rachel was a loving and caring person who didn't deserve what happened to her. She was the type of person that didn't matter the circumstances. She went out of her way to help in any way she can. Her daughter, Victoria Rivera, writes on a GoFundMe page set up to help pay for her funeral expenses. We are so devastated by her loss. The building where Lopez was found is less than a mile from her home. Her family told the station, there's nothing unusual about the location, and the 47-year-old would visit friends in that area often. Wow. Lopez leaves behind 4 children and 2 grandchildren, including one she never got to meet. Imagine losing your mom, you know. Who wants to lose their mom? Riviera had told the NBC News of New York. While no arrest has been made in Lopez's death, her family hopes someone will come forward to help bring justice. We pray that if someone knows something, they say something, Riviera writes on the GoFundMe, adding the hashtag justice for Rachel. That is so sad. And you know what? That's right. Imagine losing a mother. I know how it feels. I lost my mother at the age of 16. It doesn't feel good. And she, you know, Rachel was only 47 years old. She's young, man. That's a young mom, you know, young grandma. So whoever did this to her, I would love to get justice for Rachel. You guys, I mean, something happened. There got to be some video footage out there somewhere around that time of what happened. Her body was behind a building, decomposed all this time. And it's just sad, man. It's just really sad that this stuff is happening. And it's really sad that the family is going through this, you know? Oh, my goodness. So I send, you know, love and prayers to the family and my condolences as well. Now, let me see here. There was one other news that I wanted to report today. All right. In Brooklyn, a man who took advantage, of a 15-year-old girl he just met in Brooklyn apartment is sought by the police. Okay. Authorities are looking to identify a man who wanted for the rape of 15-year-old girl shortly after meeting her in Brooklyn last week. At approximately 6:30 p.m., the teen girl entered a private residence located in the vicinity of Avenue F and McDonald Avenue in Kensington neighborhood with the suspect who she had just met, according to officials. Now, she's 15 years old. Once inside, the individual pushed the victim onto a bed and forcibly took advantage of her. After the incident, the individual made the victim leave the apartment. The victim later called an EMS and was transported to New York City Health and Hospitals / King County, where she was treated and released. The suspect is described by police as a man with a medium complexion in his early 20s, approximately 6 feet tall, with a medium build and curly black hair. He was last seen wearing a red, white, and blue hooded jacket, black pants, Nike Jordans, red, black, and black sneakers. Officials urge anyone with any information to call the NYP Crime Stoppers hotline at 1-800-577-TIPS. Oh my gosh, man. Listen, you know, young ladies, teenagers, when you meet somebody and you meet up with them and then they take you to a building that's privately owned, I'm sorry, you don't do that. You know what I'm saying? It's unfortunate what happened to this young lady. It sucks and it's terrible because you got some weirdos out there, man. Young ladies, there are weirdos out there. You can't trust nobody these days. Nobody. Nobody. This should not have happened to her. This should not have happened to her. You know what I'm saying? It just sucks that it did. And it's like, and I hope they got a picture of him, which you will see in my commentary. But this stuff, this is ridiculous. It's like, it's crazy that stuff going on everywhere. Everywhere stuff is going on. You know? Oh, my goodness. I feel terrible for her. But ladies, let me tell you something. Parents, if you're listening, there's a movie called Megan is Missing. And I urge all parents, whether you have girls or boys, to watch that movie because it will give you insight on how these young girls are meeting guys and the guys are taking them, kidnapping them, doing what they want to them. I mean, it's just crazy. You never know who you are meeting. You have to be aware and you have to be careful. Everybody, including men, including teenage boys, including women, and including teenage girls, you have to be careful when you are meeting people because you don't know what their intentions are. You have to be careful. I stress this to my girls. You have to be careful out there because people will tell you they this way and it end up being something else. And I'm pretty sure when he met her, he was just, you know, probably this charismatic person. Like, he was like cool and everything and he was really into her, but yet he was a weirdo. He was a sicko because only weirdos and sickos do stuff like this. And if he's 20 years old, what is he going after a 15-year-old girl for? So he's a pedo. You get what I'm saying? You have to be careful out there. Because people are getting kidnapped and not coming back. Or if they're getting kidnapped, they're getting dropped off on the street, hurt, taken advantage of. You have to be careful out there. You can't trust people these days. And I can't stress that enough. You cannot trust people these days. Anyway, that is my fast report for Friday. I hope you guys have a great day. Please, you know, if you know anything about any of these subjects that I talked about, hit me up in the comment section and I will talk to you later, guys. Have a good one. Take care.